We want to find the area of the shape below. Notice how if we cut the shape here, we have a rectangle and a triangle. And therefore, to determine the area of the shape, we can determine the area of the rectangle, then determine the area of the triangle, and then sum the two areas to determine the total area. Notice how the rectangle is 18 centimeters by 6 centimeters. So we have the information we need to find the area of the rectangle. Now looking at the triangle, notice how this length is 9 centimeters. So we know the height of the triangle is 9 centimeters. But we are not given this length here, which is the base of the triangle. So let's work on determining this length. Well, because this length is 18 centimeters, and this length is 6 centimeters, and this length is 3 centimeters, we do have the information we need to determine the length of this base. Notice how the base plus these two lengths must equal 18 centimeters, and therefore the base must equal 18 centimeters minus 6 centimeters minus 3 centimeters, which equals 9 centimeters. Now we have all the information we need to find the area of the rectangle and the area of the triangle. To keep things organized, let's label the area of the rectangle a sub 1 and the area of the triangle a sub 2. Using this notation, if we let a equal the total area, we can say the total area a is equal to a sub 1, the area of the rectangle, plus a sub 2, the area of the triangle. And now let's determine the area of the rectangle. The area of a rectangle is equal to length times width, if we want base times height. Either way, the area is equal to 18 centimeters times 6 centimeters. We'll put the units on the end, so we have 18 times 6 plus the area of the triangle. The area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 base times height, so we have 1/2 times, the base is 9 centimeters, and the height is also 9 centimeters, so we have 1/2 times 9 times 9. Simplifying, 18 times 6 equals 108. So we have 108 plus 1/2 times 9 times 9. 9 times 9 is 81, and therefore we have 81/2. Before we determine the sum, let's convert 81/2 to a decimal. To do this, we divide. We would have 81 divided by 2. We first ask how many 2's in 8, which is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. We subtract. The difference is 0. Bring down the 1. Ask how many 2's in 1, which is 0. 0 times 2 is 0. We subtract. The difference is 1. We need to keep going, so we add a decimal to the right of the 1 and 81. Move it up to the quotient. Now we can add a 0 in the tenths place value and bring it down. Now we ask how many 2's in 10, which is 5. 5 times 2 is 10. We subtract. The difference is 0. The quotient is 40.5, and therefore the total area is equal to 108 plus 40.5 square centimeters, which is equal to 148.5 square centimeters. This is the total area of the given shape. I hope you found this helpful.